Yo, what's up? This is Heat and Succeed, and I'm making a video about Shawn Porter versus Adrien Broner. This is a prediction video, and let me just start off by saying this is going to be a good fight. I think this is what boxing needs. This is exactly what boxing needs. To get back onto the top, you need the young strong fighters fighting other young strong fighters, and this is a step in the right direction, and I'm very happy that it's on free TV, because it's going to be a Saturday. A guy comes home from work or whatever, he flips on the TV, he's trying to rest, and what does he see? Okay, he sees a TV show. House. All right, he sees Two and a Half Men. He sees the news, and then he says, "Oh wow, boxing." He's gonna click boxing because it's free, And that, like I said, boxing. There's a primal attraction that people have towards it. It's very primitive. It goes back. It's no different from when you were a kid, and it was after school or during school, and you seen, another kid fight with another kid. You seen a scrap go down. So it's no different from that. There's just something primitive that we love about it, even though it's bad and it's dangerous, and it's a very dangerous. Fighting is very dangerous, whether it's on the streets or in the ring. It's dangerous, but that's a whole different topic. As to who I think is going to win on June 20th, which is fast approaching, this is a fight that is occurring in 4 days. I'm very hyped for this fight. Shout out to Dante's Boxing Nation. Shout out to him. He did a very excellent job producing his own version of All Access, Broner-Porter. I appreciate it. I just got finished watching the last one. I watched the first one. I thought it was excellent. I watched the second one just now, and then I watched the third one, and I was like, man, this is really good. It's honestly better than All Access, the official show, in my opinion. And here's why. Because Dante was actually showing the technical side. That's what fascinates me as a fan. I love hearing boxers talk about the technical aspect. It was so cool seeing Kenny Porter say, look, I want, talking to Shane Mosley, saying, look, I want you to show my son some strategy. Okay? And then he said, okay, a lot of guys like to do this. And then Kenny Porter just clinched. He started grabbing Shane Mosley. And then Shane Mosley, using his experience, he knows how to get out of that hold. And that's one of the main strategy that's going to be very pivotal in this upcoming fight, because the last loss, the blueprint to beat Porter is to hold him. Okay, you pot shot, you hold. That's the blueprint to beat him. Because he's always coming at you. He's always throwing punches. He's very aggressive. He's nonstop. He's got very good at work rate and great heart. So the blueprint to beat him is to hold him. Pot shot, hold. Like I said, so I think it's very intelligent that he's training to get around that. I think it's very intelligent, and it's very good that he's being taught certain tactics, certain techniques to overcome an opponent who is clinching, which honestly, we'll see how it unfolds. Clinching is very that's not, that's a very widely used tactic in boxing, and it's a very effective tactic, even though it's illegal. Moving on, as far as Adrien Broner, I think he looks like he's in shape. You know, he's training in the Mayweather boxing gym. So, and I seen him getting advice from Floyd Mayweather himself. This could be a very good thing. This could be a very good thing, because, think about who, if you were a boxer, who would you rather receive advice from? Okay, would you rather be receiving advice from Shane Mosley, or would you rather be receiving advice from Floyd Mayweather? Now, I don't know how in depth Floyd Mayweather was. I don't know how much he was actually instructing Broner. I don't know if it was just a little bit, just a few words, or if it was, in depth. Because it seemed like Shane Mosley was giving in-depth instructions to Porter. So if it was, who'd you rather have instructing you, which legend? In my opinion, it's a no-brainer, Mayweather. Mayweather has he's just superior knowledge, in my opinion. Although that's not disrespect to Mosley, because he's also got a lot of experience and he's a veteran. So I think it's possible that Mayweather just dropped by for like a 10 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour, and then he shook the spot. I don't know if he actually was in-depth instructing Broner. I can't say if he was, but it seems like he was only giving him a brief, a very brief, lesson, I guess, or just help. Whereas with Mosley and Porter, it looked like Mosley was actually spending time in the gym, giving him very in-depth knowledge about certain techniques you're supposed to do in certain situations. So I think that's going to carry over very well for Porter. As for who I think wins this fight, I think Broner wins. Honestly, just to say it straight up, I think Broner wins. But I don't know. See, here's the thing. When Maidana beat Broner, Maidana's a different fighter than Porter. See, Maidana has... Just because Maidana is a brawler, just because Maidana is a puncher, that doesn't mean that he doesn't have skills. See, I compare Maidana, his skills, not all of his skills, but some of his skills, and his craftiness, his savvy, his ring IQ. I compare that to Bernard Hopkins. And I think Marcos Maidana did a lot of moves in his fight against Adrien Broner that Broner just wasn't, he didn't have the experience to deal with, and the proof of that is simply when Maidana punched himself out in his fight with Broner. Maidana had boxing skills to fall back on while he was tired, and Broner was stepping up the pressure on Maidana. Because if you watch that fight, Maidana whoops his ass in the first couple rounds, third round, fourth round, whatever, and then those middle rounds, not all the middle rounds, but some of the rounds in the middle and in the late rounds, Maidana has to take his foot off the gas pedal because he's tired. He's out of energy. But see, Maidana has that skill to where he knows how to fight tired. And that's something that, is very much like a Bernard Hopkins, just having all these little things you can go to, all these little different tools and gadgets in the tool belt you can go back to when you need them. So, now, this is why I say Broner wins. Porter as much as I like Porter, his attitude, his he's a gentleman, he's a class act. He's a good, strong fighter. He's young. He's fast. He has a lot of heart, a good fighting spirit. Like Shane Mosley said, he's got a very big fire in his belly to fight. But I don't think he has the skills that Maidana has. Okay? I don't think he has the little subtle things you do. The subtlety, you know, there's a very, in boxing, when you see Hopkins fight and you're just not really paying attention, you could say, okay, whatever. But there's a subtlety to what he's doing in the ring. And that applies, and that's just, that the same goes with Marcos Maidana. There's a subtlety to when Maidana's in the ring, although when Maidana is in attack mode, it might not look like he's doing, you know, he's not performing a craft, or it might just look like a, you know, you're watching a caveman in there slugging. That's not true, because if Maidana was simply a caveman, just a crude brawler with no refinement, no skills, I don't believe he would have been able to hit Mayweather the way he did in the second fight. In late in the third round, where he actually countered with the pull counter Floyd Mayweather, right? Maidana committed with a jab. He extended his jab all the way, and when he extended his jab all the way, Mayweather, that was a signal to Mayweather to throw the pull counter, right? Where he pulls his head back to get out of the way of the jab, and he comes back with a right hand over the jab. Well, Maidana anticipated that pull counter, and he countered it with his own right hand. His right hand beat Mayweather's right hand. So that's just an example that Maidana, there's more skills to Maidana than meets the eye. And you know, you can simply look at Maidana's skills simply by watching his fight with Jesus Soto Carras. I don't know what round it was, but you can just watch the fight. It's a great fight. It's a very entertaining fight. It's on YouTube. Maidana actually rolls punches, slips punches, avoids punches, blocks punches, catches punches with his gloves, catches punches on his arm, rolls with the punch, you know, slips the punch, makes his opponent completely miss and go off balance, and then counters. So like I said, this is the same thing that Broner did. Okay, that's what he's known for, slipping and countering and making a guy go off balance and then coming back with a combination. That's the same thing Maidana did. So Maidana has the skills. Okay, but this is not about Maidana, this is about Porter. Porter, on the other hand, he hasn't shown me that ability to roll punches, catch punches, make, you know, slip a punch, come back with a counter. You know, he hasn't shown that ability. Therefore, I have to go with Broner, because I don't believe strength and you know, and work out and work rate, I don't believe those two things alone are going to beat Broner. I think you know, when Maidana beat Broner, not only did he have the strength and he had the speed, you know, as far as, you know, the hustle to throw a lot of punches. He also had experience and different tactics and techniques that he was able to use against Broner to win. Right? Because, you know, and like I said, I don't know if Porter has that. I don't think he does have that. And also, on top of all that, he's fighting at a catch weight of 144 pounds. Porter, who's already a big guy, has to lose another additional 3 pounds. And if you look at Porter, if you look at that man, there's not an ounce of body fat on him. Okay, so where is that 3 pounds coming from? I'll tell you where it's coming from. I think I heard say that they're not eating protein. I heard Kenny Porter or Shawn Porter say that they're like going light on the protein. So that right there tells me that he's gonna be lighter in muscle mass. Okay, so that's another advantage for Broner. It's very much like when Canelo was fighting Mayweather, and Canelo had to go down to 152 pounds. Okay, in order to get down to that fight, I don't know. There's footage of it. You watch All Access Mayweather Canelo. You see what Canelo Alvarez is eating. He's eating vegetables. Okay, he's eating vegetables, salads. You don't really see many carbs. You don't see much protein in his diet, because he has to lose that 2 pounds, so he has to sacrifice muscle. Same with Shawn Porter, he's sacrificing 3 pounds of muscle. So hopefully he can lose the weight, but like I said, it doesn't look good for Porter. The catch weight is going to hurt him, because at 147 he was already very lean. So at 144 he's going to be dehydrated. He's going to be very, very drained, I believe. Hopefully he can retain his strength, but I'm not going to bet on it. My money's on Broner to win via decision. Let me know what you think. Who do you think takes this fight? Obviously a lot of people don't like Broner because the way he acts, he talks a lot of shit, he's an asshole. I understand that, but looking at this objectively from a bird's eye point of view, kind of like a betting man's perspective, I'll have to go with I'd have to go with the problem, Adrien Broner. I think he's just going to outbox Porter. Hopefully Porter can, use some skills and savvy and brute strength and positioning and cutting off the ring and just a whole complete game in order to nullify Broner's speed, boxing skills, defense, counterpunching. But like I said, the catch weight is going to very, very much benefit Broner, because I believe Shawn Porter will come out strong in the first 4 rounds, and then after that, it's all Broner. It's going to be all Broner. I'm telling you right now, Shawn Porter, all Broner has to do is survive that early, the early onslaught, and then once, then that catch weight is going to come into effect. Shawn Porter, after that 4th round, Shawn Porter is going to feel the catch weight. So, like I said, let me know what you think. Leave a comment. Like the video. This is an excellent fight for fans. We need more fights like this. All right. And with that, I'm out. Deuces.